Students, good morning. This is B.R. Shankar. Now we discuss about the expression for Joule Thomson or Joule Kelvin cooling of a gas obeying van der Waals equation. So according to the van der Waals equation is obeyed, the attractive forces between the molecules are equivalent to an internal pressure A by V square. The gas have excess pressure A by V square due to attractive forces between molecules. When the gas expands from volume V1 to V2, the work done in overcoming intermolecular attractions W equal to integral V1 to V2 PdV. Generally, the work done dW equal to PdV. So here, work done by the molecules, we get W equal to integral V1 to V2 PdV. But here, P equal to A by V square. So W equal to integral V1 to V2 A by V square dV. So integration of V for minus 2 is minus 1 by V. So W equal to minus A by V2 plus A by V1. If V1 and V2 represents the gram molecular volume on the high and low pressure sides respectively, the external work done by the gas is P2 V2 minus P1 V1. Hence, the total work done by the gas W equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 plus W, that is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 minus A by V2 plus A by V1. Van der Waals equation of the state for a gas is P plus A by V square of V minus B equal to RT. If expand the equation, we get PV plus A by V minus BP minus AB by V square equal to RT. Here AB are very small values. So AB by V square, the value is negligible. So we remove this AB by V square value and rearrange the equation. We get PV equal to RT plus BP minus A by V. So here we take the volume V1 for the gas, we get PV1 equal to RT plus BV minus A by V1, and for the volume V2 we get the equation PV2 equal to RT plus BP minus A by V2. Substitute these values in above equation W. Work done, we get W equal to RT plus BP2 minus A by V2 minus RT plus BP1 minus A by V1 minus A by V2 plus A by V1. So here RT plus RT minus RT are cancelled, and plus BP2 minus BP1. So here we take B as common, we get B of P2 minus P1. Plus here A by V2 minus A by V2 minus A by V2, we get minus 2A by V2, and again minus of minus plus A by V1 plus A by V1, we get plus 2A by V1. So 2A is common, 2A take as common, we get 2A of 1 by V1 minus 1 by V2. From the van der Waals equation, that is P plus A by V square of V minus B equal to RT, A and B, these constants are very small values. So eliminate these two values, we get PV equal to RT. So for the volume V1, P1 V1 equal to RT. From this, we get V1 equal to RT by P1. And for volume V2 and pressure P2, we get P2 VT equal to RT, then V2 equal to RT by P2. So substitute these values above equation, we get W equal to B of P2 minus P1 plus 2A of P1 by RT minus P2 by RT, because V1 is RT by P1, so 1 by V1 is P1 by RT, and V2 is RT by P2, so 1 by VT equal to P2 by RT. Minus as common, W equal to minus B of P1 minus P2 plus 2A by RT is common, so 2A by RT of P1 minus P2. So again, P1 minus P2 is as common, we get W equal to P1 minus P2 of 2A by RT minus B. Suppose the fall in temperature is delta T, because here we want to get the cooling equation, so temperature must be falling. So falling in temperature delta T, W equal to JH, here H is heat, J is joule constant, so that equal to J of Q equation, H is MCP delta T. Here M is the gram molecular weight of the gas, so we take joule constant. J MCP delta T equal to P1 minus P2 of 2A by RT minus B. Subject the delta T and J MCP is transferred to right side, we get delta T is P1 minus P2 by J MCP into 2A by RT minus B. This is the expression for joule Kelvin cooling. From this equation, since P1 minus P2 is positive, then delta T will be positive if 2A by RT minus B is positive. So that is 2A by RT is greater than B. 2A by RT minus B is positive, that means 2A by RT is greater than B. RT is less than 2A by RB. T is less than 2A by RB. Therefore, cooling will take place if the temperature of the gas is less than 2A by RB. Here we get T is less than 2A by RB. That means temperature of gas is less than 2A by RB. Then we get cooling will be takes place. For delta T to be 0, from above equation we get 2A by RT minus B equal to 0. 2A by RT minus B equal to 0. That is T equal to 2A by RB. T equal to 2A by RB. This temperature is called the temperature of inversion and is represented by Ti. So Ti equal to 2A by RB. Delta B will be negative. Delta T will be negative if 2A by RT minus B is negative. 2A by RT minus B is negative. That means B is less than 2A by RT. RT is greater than 2A by RB. Okay, T is greater than 2A by RB. So T is greater than Ti, because 2A by RB is Ti, inversion temperature. So T is greater than Ti. Therefore, heating will take place if the temperature of gas is more than the temperature of inversion. So the temperature of inversion Ti is defined as the temperature of the gas at which the joule Kelvin effect becomes zero and J is its sign. Okay, if the joule Kelvin effect becomes zero, then the temperature is called temperature of inversion. So results of the joule Kelvin equation. First one, if the gas is at temperature of inversion, then no cooling or heating is observed when it is processed through the porous plug. Here the gas is passing through the porous plug, that is called joule Kelvin experiment. So when we passing the gas through the forest flag, the gas must be, the temperature of the gas must be increasing or decreasing. But here first result, what is that? The gas is at the temperature of invention, then there is no change in temperature of the gas. The second one, if the gas is at temperature lower than the temperature of inversion, cooling will be takes place when it is passing through the porous plug. This is called regenerative cooling or Joule-Kelvin cooling. This principle has been used in the liquefaction of the gases. So are called permanent gases, the nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen and helium. If the gas at temperature higher than the temperature of invention, instead of cooling, heating is observed when the gas is passing through the porous plug. Okay, if the temperature of the gas is greater than temperature of invention and the gas passing through the porous plug, the gas, the temperature of the gas increases.